Hi, welcome back to another video with me, Philip Carahasson, for Therapy in London. The critical inner voice. Do you ever have that voice in the back of your mind that always tells you to stop doing things? That always says, don't try that because you won't do it. Or drink some coffee because if you drink it, you'll be able to work better. Then you drink two or three coffees and all of a sudden that voice says to you, oh, you drank too much coffee now. You're an idiot. Why did you do that? Because now you can't work. Now you can't do what you wanted to do because you're too wired on coffee. You better sit down. You better just not do anything. And then you sit down and you're resting. So you stop working because you can't concentrate. And that voice pipes up again. Why are you not working? Why are you not doing what you said you were going to do? It's always your fault. That's always what you do. You can never do anything right. You better just put on the TV. You just better play something, a game, because you can do that. That's all you can do. Ever get that? That you're not good enough all the time? And that voice that lives in us, that voice is always there and it dictates how we live our lives. But is that voice us or is that voice a part of us? So let's go back all the way to the beginning of our lives. Let's say, for example, we're in the park and we're riding a bicycle and all of a sudden we see a hill and we think to ourselves, oh, look, a big hill. I'm going to ride straight down that hill. So we set off and all of a sudden we hear, stop, don't ride so fast. You're going to fall over and hurt yourself. So you put the brakes on and stop. Maybe it's your parent. Maybe it's your brother or sister. Maybe it's a grandparent, an uncle or an auntie. And they're stopping you. They're stopping you from trying something, from doing something, because they don't want you to get hurt. They don't want you to ride down the hill, fall off your bike and graze your knee, break an arm. So this person has told us to stop. If we now go into the future and think to ourselves, why don't we try, I don't know, to go into that restaurant? Why didn't we try to create something? Why didn't we try to set up that business? Why didn't we try and live our dreams, go for that job, do that thing that we've always wanted to do? Well, that voice is established from the past. It's great at convincing you because it's trying to keep you safe. It doesn't want you to try because if you do, you're going to hurt yourself. But are you going to hurt yourself in the same way as falling off a bike? No. You're not going to hurt yourself physically, but you're going to hurt yourself emotionally. A part of your ego is going to get hurt because if you try and you fail, it's just as damaging. And I'm not saying you are going to look like a fool if you do try. In fact, I'd argue the opposite. I'd argue if you keep trying, eventually you'll get there. Eventually you'll get to the point where you actually want to be. So this voice is really detrimental to us trying new things, to us being who we want to be, achieving our goals, living our dreams. But that's not the full story, because we could demonize that voice, but as we saw in the past, it's actually helped us. That person telling us to stop and us internalizing that has helped us to not get hurt. And in the future, in the same way, physically, that voice stops us from crossing the road when we see a driver driving too fast, even though we're on a zebra crossing. So actually that voice protects us in some ways, but in other ways, it's really, really restrictive. It's stopping us from trying new things, from going out, because just in case you fail, better not try. You might get hurt. Something might happen here. So we have a bind here. Do we listen to it? Do we not? And in fact, do we have an option to listen to it? In fact, do we actually recognize it's a voice at all? So many people I speak to actually say that they don't see a critical inner voice. They just see their voice. And when we start looking at that voice and actually stepping away from it, so we can see we have our voice and we have this critical voice that's dictating to us, we can see, oh, actually, I can choose if I want to listen to it. I have the autonomy to look at that and dissect it and to think, is this helping me? Is this not helping me? Where can we go here? You can start to live in a way which means that you're not dictated to by this voice. You're not always appeasing it. You're not always fighting it. You can live in a way that's free.